Good evening po sa inyo lahat, and I just want to thank you guys so much for taking your time out to be here, and sobrang powerful po talaga ng social media ngayon. That's why sobrang thankful po kami. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat ngayon pa lang. Yung cultural differences po, to be honest, yung adjustments wala masyado kasi si Mario para siyang Pinoy talaga. Although syempre while doing yung movie po nung nasa Thailand kami, of course merong mga you have to pay respect sa kunwari nung nandun po kami sa yung parang temple po, parang meron silang ginagawang mga rituals ganyan, kunwari sa monks maghingi ng respect na parang you have to do this and make some offerings para mga ganun po yun. And si Mario po, he speaks English fluently, so no problem po. He is really like a superstar, ha? Hindi lang doon sa Thailand, pati dito, syempre, di ba? Sobrang, pag makikita mo si Mario, parang hindi niya alam na superstar siya. Sobra siyang humble, sobra siyang down to earth. And then, napanood ko yung A Crazy Little Thing Called Love na movie nila. And I was a fan, silang dalawa ni Byfern. And yun, kasali rin siya sa movie na to. May guest role si Byfern. Wala, dead man. No, me and Mario, nung nakilala ko siya talaga, first time I met him, nung nagkaroon po tayo ng meeting dito, sila, na parang na rin siya naging story conference ng konti, kasi nandun si Miss Vanessa and si Direk Rory, tas yung team niya. After nun, sumunod na yung pagpunta namin sa Bangkok para madiscuss talaga yung movie and yung kumbaga sequence per sequence na gagawin namin, kasi afternoon diretso na siya sa Ilocos eh. So parang masasabi ko na kahit dun sa konting time na yon, parang alam ko na magiging okay yung trabaho kasi napaka-cool niya talaga. And you know, off-cam si Mario, napaka-ano niya, he's very playful, very naughty. Prankster siya dun sa road manager niya. Lagi siyang gumagawa ng kung ano-ano. Lagi niyang, kunwari, ginaganyan. Pero, syempre, close sila, diba? So, hindi mo naman yun gagawin sa taong hindi mo close. So, yun, mahilig siya magbiro. Kunwari, you look so good today. Ah, really? No, just kidding. Parang mga ganon. Parang ikaw din. Nice, ha? I like your outfit. Yan. Parang mga ganon. Pero, walang seryoso talaga. So parang hindi yung magpapaka prim and proper ka na, "Hi, how are you?" Parang wag hindi. Or, "Hey, what's up?" Ganon. Ganon lang.
Ako. And then I suggested it to Malu and then she approved it. So, but it has been her strategy all along naman with Carmen Sue and all. So it matches her plans. Timing din naman yun. Palabas yung Crazy Little Thing. So familiar sa kanila, mataas ang rating. Pero Mario himself, kilala na natin siya since Love of Siam, di ba? Sa Cine Manila. So, medyo meron na siyang fanbase dito. At saka, strategy rin kasi ng star na makapag-release sa Asia. So, with Erich and Mario, hopefully, makilala si Erich sa nakabenta na kami. Meron na kaming producer na Malaysian para mabenta yung movie. Hopefully, to China. Of course, in Malaysia, sure na yon. And in Thailand. So, parang planado naman strategically.
I'd say Iba rin kasi itong movie na to dahil itong movie na to marami siyang tinatake lahat ng yung iba't ibang aspects and factors pagdating sa love, diniscuss dito sa story. So, yung level ng maturity din na ito yung klaseng na movie na paglabas mo ng sinehan, mafe-feel mo na masarap, mind love talaga. Gusto kong kantahin yung theme song.
Sample?
Huwag naman ganyan. Okay ang weather tonight. Pero konting push pa. Sige pa.
Pasaling call.
Yung ano na lang.
And Miss Erich Gonzales.
Suddenly it's magic. Sabi ko na, huwag na nga.
Pero may talent pa, di ba, rapping?
Ano ka ba naman? Go on, hindi ako ready for that. Pero yun.
Pwede mapilit.
Pwede.
Sige, rap.
Rap talaga. Beatbox na lang.
Beatbox.
Sir Enrico, mag-rap ka. For a change.
Ano ba yan?
Yes, yo. Ganun ka lang. Game.
hit it!
Sa maganda, wala siya chota, kailangan maganda, baka sa Thailand. Tama na!
Break it down, yo!
Team!
Palabas din natin si Mario!
How do you find the Filipino way of making films?
For me, to after working with the Filipinos team, I think you guys is very professional, and I learned a lot with the whole crew, yeah, including English too.
If you had magical powers, what is one thing that you would like to wish for?
If I have a magical power, I would like to speak Tagalog.
What are the things you love most about the Philippines and why?
The things I like about the Philippines, I like adobo, first of all, and I like all the people there, you know, like there. It's not like I have my best friend, if you know, I have a Filipino, my best friend. I get to know my friends since I'm a boy, so, and I know that he's a very funny guy and very happy guy. So when I went to your country, I found out that everyone is like him. Yeah.
Thank you.
Salamat po.
Okay, my question is, what's your first impression on the Philippines and Filipinos, and what can you say after coming here in the Philippines?
My first impression is I know that I have many fans in the Philippines, and the first day that I went there at the airport, I get a shock because it's like so many fans there, like, give me such a welcome. And what is the other question?
What's now your impression after going to the Philippines?
And my impression for me going to the Philippines is I got to know, like, you know, I heard like the Filipinos team that told me that after I have worked with them, I will be a family, and I really liked it because we became a family. Yeah.
Hey, let's promote the movie. You invite them.
Yeah.
You first.
Yeah, I would like to invite my Filipino fans. Yeah, I really like to let them go watch my movie with Erich Gonzales, because she is a very good actress and very good looking actress. Yeah.
More adobo for you. Good.
Yeah, thank you. And thank you for your adobo that you made me. And I would like all my Filipino fans to go watch my movie, okay? Saturday is magic.
I'll see you soon.
I'll see you soon.
Yeah, see you next month, bro. Peace out.
See. Yeah. Peace.
Thank
you. I want to thank you, everyone, for coming today.
Salamat.
Salamat po. Good night po.